Good morning, good morning, good morning, or good afternoon. But this is my morning because I stay in bed late. Listen, I just got to get online and say something. I don't know if this is for the vlog or I might post it now. I have no idea. But I wanted to say, I shared sort of like the struggles yesterday, the things that I was struggling with. And you know what? So many people reaching out and saying they got the same experiences and the same shit that they're going through with their business. And I just wanted to say, we got this. I am feeling fiery as bollocks today, and I can see the light at the end of the tunnel, and I just want to say we've got this. Like, we are gonna make it through this, right? As businesses, we stick together. Just keep sharing, keep talking, keep speaking to each other, keep sharing advice, sharing things that you find, and helping each other. Like, I felt like crap on, I think it was Friday or Saturday, whenever I posted out about, you know, falling through all them loopholes. And today, I feel so much better listening to other people sharing their story with me. So what I will say is, if you're struggling or you're having issues at the moment in your business, or you know, you're finding it hard to keep going, just talk about it, reach out to other people and speak to them. You realize you're not on your own. We're all in the same shit boat together. Like, I guess right now, I can sort of, I feel fiery, I feel good. I've had a few clients reach out to me this morning. Some new clients reach out to me this morning. So I'm feeling like, you know, maybe there's something positive happening. I can see the light at the end of the tunnel, and I just wanted to say, I just sort of record this moment and just be like, we got this. We are gonna get through this. Like, keep smashing. I even checked the stupid Boris Johnson announcement or whatever the hell was on TV this morning, because you know what? It's not gonna do anything apart from make me miserable. So I guess all we can do is just keep pushing, keep driving, keep grinding. And someone said on my post, they said something like, all you can do right now is work your ass off. So good luck, everybody. Do you know what? I came to Missguided this morning. I came to their head office because I was going to pull a prank on him. I thought, get my revenge. But you know what? I've decided to be the bigger man. I decided not to be immature. I've decided not to be childish anymore. And oh, wait. What's this? I'm quite proud of that. So, answering a long-awaited question, just how immature is Lewis Ellis? Well, it turns out pretty immature. Do you know what? I thought it'd be a bit of fun. I thought they might laugh it off. I got the idea because some guy on LinkedIn said, it's like they're mismarketing. And I was like, oh my God, what a great idea. So I thought I'd knock a little banner up for them. I'm hoping they see it and I'm hoping they laugh and it brightens someone's day. all this effort just to make someone laugh. I got up early as well to do that. Oh well, anyway, on to the next thing today. Photo shoot. I've got to go do some charity photo shoot to do with online trolling, which is quite interesting because I'm just getting trolled by a knobhead right now. I don't know about you guys, but I am always late for everything. I'm supposed to be at this photo shoot now. I'm an hour and a half behind. I don't even know if they're still going to want me, but I'm going to go 202 Kitchen. I've never been there before. Apparently it's bright pink now. It'll be quite interesting. Today I'm a pretty girl. What am I? That's gonna look so weird. You're in the vlog too. I want to introduce you to Jay Sky. Say something for the camera.
Okay, so my name's Jay Sky, we're on set for Mirror Image, and this guy filming is a legend, he's called Lewis. Love him to death.
That's me!
Hi. Yeah,
I'm going in there.
Yeah.
Only for a minute,
right? So basically, you can make him actually hold it. Yeah, do that. Stick, right? So do a few like that. Looking that way, looking that way. And then we're going to get him to do some like
Lunges.
You know, like a dog.
Like a dog?
Like a Ken doll.
Oh,
a
doll, okay. I've got the penis for that.
That looks great.
Jay, by the way, you've got to lift it for a minute or two. You can close the lens and close the camera.
Okay, yeah. No.
Do I smile or not? Do I crack it or am I? I reckon neutral. Sit on the fence. But it feel like smug today.
Now you look. You look down. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Let's do it. So just do some like looking over there. Okay, looking that way. Yeah. Perfect.
I got sweat patches.
No, nothing.
Depends where you look.
I'm really getting my blood.
Getting what? Is that?
Nice. I'm getting my blood. Getting my blood.
Literally in the middle of a photo shoot with Owen. He gave me the idea to get a camera out and do a bit of a vlog.
Say hi, Owen.
Hi, guys.
How's it going today? How are we doing, guys?
Random.
Explain that again.
Okay. Oh, no. Why can I not explain it when I've got my normal hair on? Right, it's basically... It's a mental health campaign for trolling and bullying and all the... all the money that we make is going towards the mental health charity in Manchester, Mind. So it's just a good cause to raise awareness. And I look beautiful, as you can tell.
And that's a wrap. What a great little cause, though. Those guys are doing like an anti-bullying, anti-trolling campaign and sharing their experiences of how they've been affected, how they've been impacted. And actually, you know, I had a guy today who's been a little wanker online and it can really get you down. And to be fair, what a great little cause. I'm glad I got involved. Even though I had to wear a troll's wig and have my ears sticking out looking a bit of a twat. It's worth it. Woo! Good morning. Folks, how's it going? I'm having a bit of a random day today. I came all the way down to Escape. Can you see that? I decided to meet one of our guys that reached out to a potential client. These guys need some support with their social media. They've got a really cool little ethos as well. So we had a great little catch up this morning. Just thought I'd do a little vlog and say I'm on the road. A bit tired after yesterday's antics doing the little prank video. Didn't get much sleep, but yeah, it's just one of those days. Look at this van behind. It's the brightest van ever. That's how you do advertising. That's advertising done right. But looks like we're gonna be working with another client. Today's a good day. Also, by the way, if you've not been to Escape before, there's a roller coaster on the roof, which I would recommend to anyone. Check it out. Anyway, ciao for now. Don't think about it, boy, leave her alone. Just rocked up at the cryo chamber place in Bury Whitefield, of all places. It's gonna be pretty sick. I don't know what to expect. I've heard it's fucking freezing cold. And my penis is gonna look like a chipolata sausage, but we're gonna go check it out and see what it's all about.
Oh dear.
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it. And listen, ice is back with my brand new invention. So, grabs a hold of me tight.
I can see inside.
It's gonna be cut off at -100.
One more, sorry?
Yeah, -100 is the cut off point on the pre-call. We're gonna get you in. So, it's gonna warm back up a little bit now. When we get you inside the chamber, it's gonna go colder than that. We set it so that it stays above -110.
Okay.
110 is where all the science, all that is, we like to say the magic happens.
I don't understand how I don't freeze to death.
Because, very simply, the fact is that the chamber is completely safe to use because your core temperature stays the same.
Okay.
So the blood is going to rush from the surface of your skin and it's going to rush to protect all your vital organs and your core. So your core stays 37 degrees, which is why it's safe to use. Any more than 3 minutes, the set's hypothermia can start to set in, which is obviously why we, everybody, 3 minutes is the maximum you come in for. But all the benefits are you're going to get a massive endorphin boost from this, so you should feel really good when you come out. You're going to have a big metabolism boost, so you might find you're hungry after. I don't know if you've done any training today, but if you do training after the chamber, you can burn up to an extra 800 calories in the 6 hours after you've been in the chamber. There's loads of benefits to it, and you should have a really good sleep tonight as well. That's the other thing. It's the, you know, because you get that endorphin and metabolism boost, you then get that trough at the end as well. So, see how you do.
Simple.
I'm just like, what am I saying?
You'll love it. Everybody.
She needs more sick off while you're in it.
That's it, you're going to pass it over the top to me. There you go.
I'm touching the sides, I'm going to
you definitely not touch it.
Don't touch sides, I'm just touching the
sides. You'll be fine. Take your robe off for me when you're ready. Yeah. I can open the door if you need a bit more room to get it off.
I've got tits at the moment, I don't want to be caught on camera with you. Oh, fucking hell.
Cold. You'd be disappointed if you came in and it was warm.
Oh.
Just going to pull this cord tight for you just to keep the nitrogen in the tank, okay?
Matt, you're already freezing.
Okay. If you need me to stop the chamber at any point, we can stop it. Not many people will ask me to stop it, just so you know. No pressure. 3 minutes. Mind over matter, that's what I always say. Nobody uses the chamber for the 3 minutes that they're in it, or very few people do. You have to really love the cold to want to be in here.
I feel like I'm in a... Oh!
Go on, I feel like you're in a what?
So you walk through Tesco's?
Yeah. Oh, there you go, in the freezer department, but you've got no clothes on. There you go. You do warm up really quickly when you come back down.
It's the first time I'm like, yeah, I had no idea what to expect.
But I think you're the kind of person that you're going to get out of and I think you're going to get that massive adrenaline boost. I feel like you've got a bit of a boost already. You're laughing your head off. That's the difference.
Final 5 seconds. Nipple feels like it's going to drop off.
Yeah,
imagine.
I'm joking.
Oh,
definitely.
Cheers, mate.
You're done.
Woo! That does look good, doesn't it?
Here you go. How'd you feel?
Good.
Here you go. See?
One day I'll get my penis back and I'll cap it. That was freezing. But you know what? I actually feel quite good now. The feeling's coming back in my arm. I can see how it would help with muscle recovery. It's like an ice bath, but a really fast one. But more effective. Would recommend. Definitely the weirdest thing I've done this week. Do you know, I'm already starting to regret tonight. I've invited my mates to come to this Halloween event. They're nightmares. Like, the worst types of people. I'm hoping they don't embarrass us, take the piss, but yeah, it should be quite scary. I'm excited to see how it goes. Not been to one like this before. The drive-in. Drive-through, not drive-in.
You gonna go on the vlog?
Fuck off. I hate cameras. I hate cameras. He hates cameras. Just because I know I need to have in this video what's going on here. He went, do you want to set some fireworks off? For no reason, so that's what we're doing.
Oh shit. I don't want to take it over there, are you?
No, it stays in the box. Weird ass.
Ah!
Your neighbours like you.
When you go through these doors and you see things that no one don't never wants to see. But don't you worry, because sister's waiting for you. So you give her your best smile. Go, 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 go.
I can give you all beautiful forever smiles. Oh, watch out for the psychotic inmates, or make sure they don't get you. And remember to smile.
Thank you.
How's it going, mate? We're actually in the boot of the car because we jumped out and thought we'll get some great footage. It should look sick, but we don't know yet.
Yeah, we've got the worst driver ever, so we've nearly ended up over the back about four times, so...
And I'm pretty sure we're not even on the trail anymore.
Recommend it to everyone. Literally. Just get to it. Like, brilliant. Brilliant experience.
16 acres. 16 acres. That's massive. I think we just finished it, and to be honest, it was pretty decent. Fair play to him. Although I wouldn't recommend going to the pretty mate's car because he drives like a dickhead.